Carmen, I wanted to have you on here tonight because you've coached at the pros in MLS. You've played the game as a pro. You've coached youngsters. You've coached university kids. And simply, I wanted to lighten it up in this holiday season, Carmen. I don't want to talk about 4-4-2s, development, how we go about structuring this player. I want to talk about, as a coach yourself, Carmen, what is so gratifying for you as a coach? Is it something that maybe a player sees you 5-10 years ago that you coached and sees you maybe at a coffee shop or the shopping mall and says, hey, coach, thanks so much for believing in me. Thanks so much for helping me really understand the game inside and out. What is so gratifying for you as a coach, Carmen?
That's spot on. I mean, it's about people and people and managing people and managing their confidence. And whether they're the 35th player on your team or the first player, you need to make sure that they're needed. And it doesn't take much to be good, to be nice, to make sure that they're involved, and you know, a pat on the back. That development of personal achievement is way more important than a 4-4-2, way more important than all those things. And the most successful coaches get that part of it right, I think. I mean, my relationships with my coaches now that I've had in the past, and that have kind of groomed me, like a Bob Gansler, or Emilio Hernandez, or even a Peter Felicetti, Peter Pinizotto. Those are people that you know, come to know you as a person, and they appreciate you as a person. And those are the things that are most important. The smile, the handshake of a kid that you know that you didn't do much, but you patted them on the back. You know, when things weren't going right, you made them feel that, you know, you're still important. There's still things that you need to do, and the message that you just said about ensuring that they're at a good place and they're prepared to be better people. That's the most important thing, and that they take something out of this. And the thing that's most fulfilling is giving back, for sure. Giving back, and whether it's I don't have the tactical capacity, or it's as many people may argue, but I have the capacity of just being a good person, which is most fulfilling. And
you said it bang on. Coaches, unfortunately, have a lot of issues nowadays, especially with parents coming at them about their kids with playing time, or their kids should be the ones taking the free kicks, or you name it. It goes on and on and on. And coaches have a lot of pressures. But I think what's important and what's key that you mentioned in that message is communication, Carm, from the first player all the way down to the 21st player or the 20th player or the 18th player. They all feel part of a family. And I think as a coach yourself at the university and other levels, you understand that communication is key with the player today.
Yeah, I mean, as far as that's definitely important. The best thing I can communicate to parents sometimes is, hey, it's okay if your child fails. That's part of it. Don't let them hide behind you. Let them fail. It's part of life. It's part of maturing. It's part of character building. That's the one thing that parents need to understand, that you need to let them out there, and they'll be successful after they fail. And there's not one of us that can say that, hey, we've never failed. We've never not been successful at something, or we've never not been, we've never made mistakes. But that's part of growing up, and that's part of developing who we are.
Carmen, just before we let you get back to your event there, we won't keep you much longer, but I got to tell you, to me, it was a testament to yourself as a human being, as a person, when unfortunately you lost your dad a couple months back. And the amount of people at the funeral home that were in attendance was something that I've never, ever, ever seen. And that must have really warmed your heart, your family's heart, to see players, former coaches, teammates of yours come out to show the respect, because you yourself showed them respect, whether it was as a teammate or as a coach. And I think that's got to never be forgotten by you in that situation.
Yeah, it was nice. It was a commemoration to someone that I loved a lot, and it was a product of who he was as well. I mean, he taught me how to be a good person and a good friend, and how to enjoy people and make sure that you always live life with humility and with integrity, and you make sure you do things with ability. And all that stuff on that day was a good commemoration to who he was and how I've kind of made sure I lived my life. So yeah, that was important to me, and
Carm, we'll close it out with this. What advice you want to give out to those young aspiring coaches out there that are just starting out, that they want to get to where you're at, winning national championships, being on the bench with TFC and MLS. What advice would you give to them about, dealing with players, young or old?
It's not about you. It's not about what you are as a coach, is how you give to the player. It's how you impact them every day. Do it with a smile. Do it. Make sure you take care of the preparation part of it, but the most important thing is that you do it with a smile, and that child wants to be there every day. That's the most important thing. And as you grow as a coach, you'll realize that the way you manage that child and the way you manage their personal achievement, the way you manage their every day, is going to be a massive impact. So that's the main thing, is make an impact. It doesn't have to be as a Jose Mourinho, but it definitely has to be with the things that you can control. And that's being happy and being there for them and making and that part of it for sure.